The plenary paper that's being discussed now is a paper looking at the treatment of rectal cancer patients. Rectal cancer has long been a model of what's called multidisciplinary care in cancer, where you need management includes multiple modalities of therapy, in this case, medical oncology or chemotherapy, radiation, and surgery. And the optimal outcome for patients with rectal cancer, since really for the last 50 years, has always been thought to include chemotherapy, radiation, and surgery in a sequence. And the sequence has been debated. Since 2004, the standard of care has been a combination of chemotherapy and radiation first, and then surgery, and then perhaps chemotherapy after the surgery. The study that we're presenting looks at asking the question, do we need to do all of that to cure patients? So as with breast cancer, for example, when we used to do radical mastectomies and gradually worked our way back to doing just lumpectomies, in this case, do we need to do radiation in all patients? And so the study, I was part of the team that designed the study, and we launched it in the NCI cooperative groups about 10 years ago, where we randomized patients to either chemotherapy alone and then surgery, or chemotherapy radiation and then surgery. And it's not easy to randomize patients where you're going to half the patients may not get a treatment that's standard. And so they're taking it on faith that you actually believe this, the results will be equivalent, or that it will justify omitting a therapy that we've been using and assuming we needed. So the study accrued, it took about 7 years to accrue. It's over 1,000 patients. It's hard to accrue a study like this. You need everybody to sign on. So you need medical oncology, surgical oncology, and radiation doctors to all agree. Because if one of the team doesn't agree with that treatment, then the patient won't participate in the study. You also need patients, of course, to get treated at centers where the study is being conducted. And for all of those reasons, it took a long time to accrue the study. The study finished accrual about 2 years ago. And the data presented at the meeting shows that, in fact, in a subset of patients, not every patient with rectal cancer, but about a third of the population of patients would meet the criteria that we included in this study. Those patients do not need radiation therapy to have the same outcome in terms of survival and quality of and time to progression or recurrence, but also they have a better quality of life in general because they're not getting radiation. It's also a cost difference. So you save the cost of radiation. So on many parameters, this is a step forward. Much harder, not as sexy as a new drug or using artificial intelligence or an immunotherapy, but in fact, by deleting a treatment that we determined we didn't think we needed, and now we showed we don't need, you make patients better and you improve their outcome without doing as much harm as you might have done otherwise.